Second startup, please join us. It's going to be InnoHealth, so it will be more into the medtech sector right now. I think it's disinfected. I think we're almost ready.
Okay. Yes.
Do you have to click? Oh yeah. Also, please take it. All right. So if you're ready, we can set the clock to 3 minutes.
How does this work?
Probably the one in. Oh yeah, it works now. So the one in the middle. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. I think we're ready. So take it away in just a second. Lim 8, could we please set up the time to 3 minutes? Just small technical.
No.
Oh, it's almost up. All right, take it away.
Okay. Hello, everyone. We are Inu, and I would like to talk about endometriosis, or the presence of endometrial-like groups of cells from the womb lining outside the uterine cavity. And it has symptoms like painful periods, excessive bleeding, infertility. Now, I would like to ask you to think about 10 women you know, your mother, your sister, your friends. What if I tell you that it's almost certain that at least one of them has this disease? That's the prevalence of endometriosis. 1 in 10 women in the world have it. And this is a very typical patient journey with a woman with endometriosis. You see, it takes on average 8 doctors. And in this case, and this is a real case, it took 17 years to be diagnosed. You see, we have these painful periods, and society tells us it's just normal. It's just part of having a period. And we think it's also normal. And you may think, wow, 17 years, that's a lot, right? But the truth is, the average in the whole world, it's 10 years to have a correct diagnosis. So this is the wake-up call we want to bring. Stop normalizing your symptoms. And Inno wants to break this vicious cycle of misinformation and around our menstrual symptoms and lower down the barrier for affected women to seek early specialist advice. And how are we going to do it? First of all, we are based on 4 key points of integrated care. First of all, we have a highly personalized symptom tracker with focus on the symptoms that matters regarding endometriosis, and with continuous tracking, we offer a recommendation of diagnosis after 3 months. We also have a cognitive behavioral therapy, a holistic solution, 28 days, split in audio sessions of 50 minutes, clinical proven to control pain. We are backed up by science because we worked together in a co-pilot project with the University of Melbourne, and we did a mini clinical study with 6 women, and they all perceived that the content was helpful for their pain. And alongside, we offer nutrition tips, anti-inflammatory nutrition tips that is really important to this untackled market. So we are not just a normal period tracker. We are highly personalized medical with a personalized focus on this group. And we are aiming to convert 15% of the 6 million women in Germany that suffer from severe menstrual pain. And with a free model of $59.99, already tested, 2023 is our year. And why so? Because we are a medical certified product and we reach our break-even point in the second quarter. My name is Katarina, I'm the CEO, and I'm back up with these amazing and highly skilled women, and also psychologists and medical doctors specialize on the field. We are aiming for a seed funding of $500K to start our B2C market in January 2021. So if you resonate with our cause, please join our mission of helping women conquer their menstrual pain.
Super, thank you very much. It's time for the questions. Christian?
Hi. Thank you for your presentation, and very well done for asking for something. But my first question is, you said you've done a 6-patient study. Mm-hmm. That's quite light in the world of clinical trials. Are you planning on a further study?
Yes, so we did a co-pilot project with 20 women with the University of Melbourne. We did our, now because we translated, we're working with German population, so we did, and we are planning to partner with a research organization now in November 2020 to have a bigger group, control group.
And of your 500,000 spend, how much of that is clinical study?
Yeah, clinical study, hiring, onboarding, and product development. That's our aiming.
What's your customer acquisition strategy? How are you planning to get women to use this app?
So we have, as I said before, this is the most common disease we never heard of. And we have this wake-up call, stop normalizing your symptoms. So we are partnering also with influencers in Germany already. They are participating actively in the customer acquisition. And this is the subject. Femtech is a highly trend market now, and we are thinking using like social media channels like Instagram, TikTok to provide education and also promote to talk about the subject, and that's what we want.
Any other questions?
So have you already started, are women using this app? Because from what I'm seeing, it requires a lot of engagement.
Yeah, so we have been, right now we have the validation of the product. We already have a 60 customer base of women that want to use it in on a daily basis. We are currently developing the MVP, but they have been testing the app and the audios at the same time. Yeah, we are aiming to have the like a full product in January.
So you have this huge solution with so many features already built, and you have 60 people that are willing to try it.
Yes, it's not.
It's a huge bet.
Yeah, it's not already 100% completed. We want to. We have this lean development cycle where we want to have sure of the features that are most necessary. We already prioritize it. We want to now make it better and better. But yes, in January we have.
Yeah. Can you go back to your slide with competitors' analysis?
Yeah.
How do you plan to secure your position on the market in the long term regarding your IP protection, etc.?
Yeah, so we hold the IP rights from the cognitive behavioral therapy. We are planning to trademark the full entire product once we also have the investment.
Yeah, you said you hold the rights in which form?
The cognitive session, the 28 days therapy session, this cognitive behavioral therapy that is clinical proven to control the pain. So we hold already the IP rights for it. And and we want to trademark the entire product later on.
All right, any other questions?
So it's like a mindfulness app that's focused on people with this specific disease to help control pain, right?
Yeah, so cognitive behavioral therapy is slightly different from meditation. The cognitive behavior actually works on change this perception of pain. So it was clinical proven that women could perform their daily lives better by using this 28-day session. And the pain, the perception of pain, highly reduced. So meditation is more like relaxation, and this is actually working on the problematic.
Thank you very much. We have to wrap it up. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Big applause. Thanks.